A useless life. There was once a man named June who lived in a small village in the mountains. June was known throughout the village for his laziness and lack of ambition. He spent his days lounging around, sleeping and daydreaming, while the other villagers worked hard in the fields or at their trades. June had always been seen as the black sheep of his village. People would often ask June what he wanted to do with his life, but he had no answer. He had no goals, no dreams, and no desire to achieve anything. His life seemed completely useless to everyone around him. One day, a wise Zen master came to the village. He was known to be one of the greatest teachers in the land, and people from all over came to seek his guidance. The villagers were excited to learn from him, and they gathered in the village square to listen to his teachings. June, who was sitting on the outskirts of the crowd, was approached by the Zen master. "Young man, what is your purpose in life?" he asked. June was taken aback by the question. "I don't know, sir. I've never really thought about it," he replied. The Zen master nodded. "It is not uncommon for people to go through life without a clear purpose. But it is important to have one. Without a purpose, life can seem meaningless and empty." June was intrigued. "But how do I find my purpose?" he asked. The Zen master smiled and said, "Finding your purpose is not something that can be done overnight. It requires patience, self-reflection, and a willingness to take risks. But the journey towards discovering your purpose can be just as meaningful as the destination itself." With those words, the Zen master turned and walked away, leaving June deep in thought. Over the next few days, June began to reflect on his life. He realized that he had been living without any direction, simply going through the motions of each day without any purpose. He knew that he needed to change, but he wasn't sure how. As he was walking by the river one day, June noticed an old woman struggling to carry a heavy basket of fish. Without hesitation, he rushed over to help her. The woman was grateful for his help, and June felt a sense of satisfaction from assisting her. From that day on, June began to look for small ways to help others in the village. He would offer to carry groceries for the elderly, help farmers with their harvest, and even offer to babysit children. Each time he helped someone, June felt a sense of fulfillment and purpose that he had never experienced before. As he continued to help others, June began to notice something else. The other villagers started to take notice of his actions and began to emulate them. The village became more connected, and people began to work together to achieve common goals. June had unknowingly become a catalyst for change in the village. One day, the Zen master returned to the village. As he walked through the streets, he noticed the change that had taken place. He saw people helping each other, working together, and living with a sense of purpose. And in the center of it all was June, who had gone from being seen as the village's useless man to being a beacon of hope and inspiration. The Zen master approached June and smiled and said, "You have found your purpose, young man. You have shown that even the smallest actions can make a difference in the world. Continue to be the change that you wish to see in the world, and others will follow your example." June smiled back at the Zen master. He had found his purpose, and he knew that he would spend the rest of his life helping others and making a difference in the world.